Dear students, let's study the common emitter connections of a transistor. As we already discussed in case of common emitter connections, emitter terminal of a transistor is common for both input and output terminals. Let's have a look on the circuit diagram, which is showing us the connections of a transistor with emitter common to both input and output terminals. This circuit shows the common emitter connections of a PNP transistor. Here, input side, we consider the terminals base and emitter, and for output side, we consider the terminals collector and emitter. Here in the circuit, to keep base emitter junction forward biased, we put a battery VBB, and to measure base current and the input voltage, that is voltage across base and emitter, we put a voltmeter and an ammeter here, which are V1 and A1. Similarly, to measure output current and voltage, that is IC and collector emitter voltage, we keep two devices, an ammeter A2 and voltmeter V2 in the circuit, and to keep collector junction reverse bias, we put a battery VCC. However, the batteries are variable voltage sources which can be used to change the polarity as well as potential difference across the junctions. And to draw input and output characteristic of the common ammeter junction, first, we plot the variation of a base current with the base emitter voltage, which we term as input characteristic. And in this input characteristic, we can say it will just be similar to the forward bias PN junction, because base emitter junction here is forward bias. If we plot the curve of variation of base current with base emitter voltage, it'll almost look like a forward bias in which up to knee point the current will be very small, after which it will increase. And say this plotted at a specific value of collector emitter voltage VCE1. Now in this situation, if we increase the collector emitter voltage, then in this situation, if we increase the voltage across collector emitter junction, more of emitter current is pulled toward collector side, and base current will decrease. So if we increase the voltage, the curve will slightly drop, as there won't be much effect on the base current. Say this VCE2, where we can see that VCE1 is more than VCE2. If we increase the voltage, it will be less than VCE2. So, on increasing the collector emitter voltage to VCE2, the base current will slightly drop, because more of emitter current will pass through the collector side. And if we just decrease the value of VC below this VCE1, it will slightly increase. There won't be much effect, we can see. The variation will be very small. Say if it is VC3, here we can write that VC3 will be less than VC1, because if we decrease the reverse biasing of collector junction, the collector current will slightly drop, and due to which base current will slightly increase. So it will almost be like a forward bias junction, and there won't be much variation in base current which we can see on varying collector emitter voltage, which is input characteristic of a common emitter connection for a transistor. Now, if we just draw the output characteristics for this common emitter junction, you can see input characteristic we are plotting between IB and VBE. Similarly, output characteristic we draw between IC and VCE at specific values of base current which is passing through base. And here you can see, if we just plot the variation of collector current with the collector emitter voltage, then we can say if collector emitter voltage is not there, then no current will flow, so graph will start from origin. And if we increase the collector emitter voltage in the beginning, emitter current will pass through it, which will increase, and later on it will almost become constant, but it will have a slight variation. So in this situation, we can say this graph will look like the situation when we can say the value of B's current is say 10 microampere, which is very small. So in this situation, we can say it will rise very slowly. And if we increase the value of B's current, then we can directly state in that situation emitter current will also proportionately increase. And on a slight increase in B's current, the emitter collector current will increase significantly. So this curve will look like a situation like this. Say this plotted at B's current equals to say 30 microampere. Or even if we further increase it, it will go on to this level. Say here IB is 50 microampere. You can see a significant difference in collector current can be seen on changing the base current. And the effect of change in collector emitter voltage will not much, because almost the value will be constant or slightly increasing. Here again, like common base connections, we can divide the characteristic or operating zone of transistor into three zones. One is the zone when the effect of base current is significant on the collector current. This is called saturation zone or saturation region, where if collector emitter voltage is slightly changed, effectively it will largely affect on collector current. And after the saturation region, not much effect of varying collector emitter voltage be there on collector current. So this region we call active region, and in most of the cases transistor is operated in active region. And if we just talk about a small zone when IB is equals to 0, approximately 0, this is the region we call cutoff region, in which we can say the both the junctions are reverse biased and a very small current flows. If we talk about the collector current, a very small current flows, which we term as ICEO. About this we'll discuss in detail when we talk about the three operating regions of transistor and common emitter zone in the next section.